to say to you that the relationship between city leadership and university is very strong.
Can it get stronger, I presume?
Of course, you know, all relationships can get stronger. I just wanted to make one observation about your opening remarks. I'll not be the first president to reach out to the community. As I read the history of this university, look at our earlier presidents. This university was supported, sustained by this community. So I'll be just bringing Western back to our roots. So that's the journey that I'm taking with my colleagues.
Just perhaps it sounds a bit crass, but as the relationship improves, what's in it for the city? What's in it for us?
Well, it's
Badgers come in ranked 7th in taking possession of those turnovers and steals, pardon me, ranked 3rd in steals, so the Mustangs up against it.
Hit and Letty to the left side, and one opportunity coming for the veteran forward out of London. Certainly a few London connections up and down both rosters. The Western Mustangs, of course, sporting local talent, both from the City of London and surrounding areas. The Brock Badgers coming to southwestern Ontario and pillaging the recruiting scene as well, as we will see London native Jenilyn Yumel before the game is out, we are certain. Kunick now, sister of former Mustang star, Ashley Kunick, and there is Kunick at the arc, long three, just short. Rosencrantz second, oh, board of the game. Always active in that high post. Polishuk, great find from the big gal Rosencrantz. And Daly controls things for these Mustangs here now. Jenny Vaughn, all-star point guard for the Mustangs, leading the charge. Letty at the arc. Rosencrantz giving her all kinds of space. McDonald has a huge mismatch. Daly from the arc, no good. Rosencrantz putting a stamp on this game early. Polishuk. Santilli, the rookie. Brock Badgers in their starting lineup. They go 5-4-3-2-1 in terms of years of experience. That's the rookie. Santilli launched the three, no good. Polishuk, oh, board and converts.
The Mustangs will have to find a way to control the Badgers in the paint, giving up the offensive rebounds in the early going here. Cannot allow that to happen throughout the game.
And as we look at the stats coming in, Andrew, you mentioned certainly the one that does not bode well for the Mustangs, turnovers versus the Badgers' propensity for taking the ball away. As you see Rosencrantz get a hand in. 3 seconds on the shot clock. Daly forced a launch. Laura Daly, deep three ball. 4-3 early going. Pardon me, 6-4 early going. Of course, Mustangs back in the lead. Letty and Daly doing work for the Stangs already. Polishuk now. Skip pass. Kunick wide open. Downtown just short. Here comes Vaughn pushing back for the Mustangs. Mustangs would love to get into the full court game and use their athleticism against these Badgers. Here's Kunick off the steal. McDonald couldn't handle the pass. Mackay up ahead. No early offense for the Badgers. They will reset. Kunick with the ball in her hands. Nice inside look. Polishuk can't finish the gimme. McDonald clears. Daly head on a swivel as she heads up the court. Letty, great position. Early double team. But Letty unable to make the move, whistled for the 3 seconds in the key. Got caught in a great spot, but a quick double team by the rookie Santilli, forcing the ball out of Letty's hands.
The Badgers doing a great job defensively in the paint there. The Mustangs will need to take a page out of the Badgers' book in paint play.
Here is Kunick, now finds Mackay, high post for Rosencrantz, and this Badgers offense, quite an open offense right now, certainly working through that high post with Rosencrantz, allowing her to make the decisions with the ball. Of course, when you're seeing a zone defense of the 2-3 that the Mustangs are employing, no surprise that you want to look to that high post area to try to force one of the bottom defenders to come up. Badgers not proving they can shoot their way, the Mustangs, out of the zone. Santilli, three ball! Kayla Santilli, the rookie, out of Brantford.
Mustangs allowing the Badgers all sorts of time from beyond the arc. It was a matter of time before Santilli converted on an opportunity.
Not surprising, though, the Mustangs electing to go with that zone, aside from being one of their bread and butter defenses. The Badgers come into this game shooting only 28% from the arc. Mustangs can't get a shot off. Great defense by the Badgers. Head coach Brian Schenk for the Mustangs will have to try to find some answers. Mustangs trail by a single point thus far, 7-6. On top are the Badgers, and his first sub coming into the game. Rosencrantz at the hoop, can't finish at the rim. Moss off the bench, ready to check in for the Mustangs. Here is Letty backing down her man, but she is going to get called for the offensive foul. That's a great job by Santilli to give a little bit of space there to create the whistle opportunity for the officials.
Both these two teams coming into action this afternoon, fresh off the heels of road victories. The Brock Badgers defeated the McMaster Marauders 73-64 last time out, while the Western Mustangs defeated the Guelph Griffins 73-50.
The Badgers now on the court, couple of subs both ways. Sarah Mallon having checked in for the Brock Badgers. The Mustang faithful will certainly remember her, one of the best three-point shooters the Mustangs had in recent years. As Mackay comes up short, Moss with the box out, possession for the Mustangs. You gotta watch Mallon anytime she's on the court. She can be a real zone buster for the opposition. Brock ahead 7-6 right now, as Daly set to inbound. Substitutions continue here both ways.
Get everyone into the game, get the feel for the opponent, get the blood flowing.
Lot of contact, no whistle until the ball lands out of bounds. Hancock thought she might have had the whistle. She ran right into Sam DeJong. 6 foot forward in her third year out of St. Catharines. Quite the nice catch for the Brock Badgers, having landed both DeJong and Rosencrantz in the same recruiting class. Two big forwards who have really clogged up the paint here for the Badgers, providing that interior presence that is oh so needed in OUA basketball. Badgers now pushing back the other way. Gallinardo, DeJong at the arc at the top. Polishuk and Mackay remain as starters for the Badgers. Here's Mallon, three-pointer. Mallon loves these rims, can't finish. Mackay clears. She'll get another look. Mustangs giving her all day to shoot. Here is DeJong, 10-footer, no good. Good battle on the boards. Moss clears.
Neither of these two teams shooting very well in the early going, as Fawn goes hard to the rim. Unable to finish, she'll head to the line. Both teams really need to improve their shooting here in the opening quarter. Only a 7-6 game, and the Brock Badgers being given all sorts of time to take their shots and just not hitting.
Jenny Vaughn can make a living at that free throw line. She has one of the quickest steps in the league at the line this season. Certainly knows what to do. Just under 80% on the year is Jenny Vaughn. And the announcer's kiss of death right there, complimenting her free throws. Under 4 minutes to go. First quarter action, 7-7. The score knotted. As you said earlier, Andrew, the first match between these two. First half nothing was decided at the halftime buzzer. It was 32 apiece going into the locker room after 20 minutes of play, and certainly this one's looking to shape up much the same way. Of course, the Mustangs, as you mentioned, looking up at the Badgers in the standings. Badgers come in 11-6 on the season. The Mustangs 7-9. Brock good for second place, so Laurier close on their heels. And the Mustangs trying to hold on, if not improve on that number six spot in the standings. Of course, top six in the West qualify for the playoff picture. Vaughn hard to the hoop, no good. Hancock missed time to jump.
The Mustangs have done a fine job this season sticking around in the OUA West. Of course, after losing the graduating Muddy Hutzler this season, it's been a bit of a retooling type season for the Mustangs, but they are still a force to be reckoned with in the Western Division.
Mal an 0 of 2 from downtown, but she knows only one thing to do when she's open at the arc. That is to lift. Mustangs employing that active zone there. Sarah Mallon reminding the crowd of what she did oh so well for a couple of years in the purple and white. And Knox has the ball go off her feet out of bounds. That one going to turn over to the Badgers. Subs continue. Starters back into the game for the Badgers. Two for two trade here. Two starters out, two back in with Santilli and Kunick. We'll join DeJong, Mallon, and Gallinardo on the floor. It's Vaughn, Knox, Daly, Moss, and Hancock for the Mustangs. No size out there for the Mustangs. Moss having to play the pivot, and DeJong exploiting that. Timeout having to be called here by the Mustangs. Head coach Brian Chang going to sort things out on his bench as he picks up the clipboard. As you look, 12-7 the score now. The Badgers in front. And Letty getting set to check back into the game for the Mustangs as you see her motion to the officiating crew. You look at what DeJong and what Rosencrantz have been doing to these Mustangs already, Andrew. And if you're sitting there in the coach's huddle there, put yourself in Brian Chang's shoes. He's got the clipboard. Are you sticking with his zone defense as long as you're letting them run through the high post like that?
No, they had to find a way to control those two players. You know what? It was all tied up 7-7 just moments ago, and you cannot allow the Brock Badgers to get on a run here to wrap up the first quarter. Runs like that can really shift the momentum. Brian Chang needs to get a hold of his group and head back out there and get a strong finish here with 2:34 left in the first quarter. They have to find a way to equalize the momentum that Brock has grabbed hold of here in the closing moments of the opening quarter.
Well, and certainly the way that the Mustangs look to do it, we know on a Brian Chang coach team, that's going to be defense, 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 the offense flowing through and hopefully getting that transition game. So you know that he is trying to work something out on the grease board there to control that Badger attack, leading to transition baskets. You got to know what Sarah Mallon is when she's on the floor. She's something that can be a real zone buster, of course, for those Badgers. And conversely, for these Mustangs, you've got an athletic lineup out there right now with Hancock, Knox, Daly playing the wings, Letty at the pivot, Vaughn on the ball. So certainly there will be opportunities. You see some full court pressure. There's Mallon picking one away. Gallinardo now gets early offense going here for the Badgers. Turnovers are going to kill you.
Yeah, exactly. As we said off the top, the turnover rate for the Mustangs this season, anytime you're ranked number three in all of Canada in that category, things aren't going to bode well for you, and that's been the case here in the first quarter.
Great defensive stand by the Mustangs following the turnover. Here now is Knox. Finds Daly. Nothing brewing as the Badgers pack the key. Hancock! Three-pointer. Annabelle Hancock stretch the defense. The Badgers content to live in the paint. The Mustangs going to make them pay from the outside, shooting just under 40% on the season. High post once again. DeJong. Contact on the arm. That'll be just the third foul of the quarter here for these Mustangs. Set to check into the game is Walensky for Western. Line change for the Badgers, it seems. Rosencrantz among those coming back out. And London native Jenilyn Yummel into the game, wearing number 8 for the Brock Badgers. She in the foreground of your picture there at the three-point arc. Badgers rotating around the perimeter. Yummel looking for a step. Shot clock an issue. She'll have to launch. gives it up to her teammate. That one swatted away by the Mustangs. Walensky up with it. She will settle things down. Finds Hancock now. Knox running the baseline. Letty, great position. She's got one-on-one with Rosencrantz. Finds Knox on the skip. Lacey! Knox! Stretching defense. We got a ball game, folks. 13-12.
Terrific pressure down court there for the Mustangs. Battling back here as we wrap up the first quarter. That's exactly the type of rush they needed. Another turnover here for the Mustangs.
2-on-3, Daly from the arc. Laura Daly! Defense leading an offense for the Mustangs. Lacey Knox creating havoc with her length on top of this zone.
Right as we call out the Mustangs for their 41% shooting this season, back come the Mustangs as if they heard us mentioning it, as they have finished up this first quarter on fire.
20 seconds remain, 3-second differential shot and game clock. Hancock has to throw one up, looks for Letty. That one out of bounds off of the Badgers. It will remain Mustang possession, only 10 on the shot clock. Get a quick look here at that last play. The steal at the top by Knox. Great transition. She found Daly with her feet planted the arc. Speaking of Daly, Laura Daly takes it right to the hoop as we see her on the three ball, but she is called for the offensive foul. This one of those unusual type of calls, however. She is being given credit for the basket. Basket does count. However, foul after the shot. And so possession will go over to the Badgers. The basket counts, but Badger possession. No free throw to follow as the foul was called on Daly. 18-12 with 10 seconds and counting on the clock. Badgers will have to look for something quick. Rosencrantz all alone, high post, dropped the shoulder, and Letty. She does that, Andrew, better than anybody in Ontario.
Court now. The Mustangs will take possession. Just 3 ticks left on the clock. Quick opportunity to check the ball in and maybe heave a prayer here.
Hancock gets it to Knox. Knox on the run. Gets it to Walensky. The extra dribble cost her. Basket goes. And that one counts, say the officiating crew. They might get together and talk about this. I thought the extra dribble cost them here. We'll see if we get a replay with sound. Not sure that we can. However, that one, if this was the NBA, they'd be taking another look. Of course, some of those resources simply not available. Walensky took the dribble, and they're going to count it. As you see, feet well inside the arc. An obvious two ball on that one. And Walensky getting credit. That one, a real momentum play for these Mustangs. 20-12, they take the lead into the break. Andrew, what has impressed you about the hot shooting of this Western Mustangs?
Just the way they finished up that quarter with 37 remaining in the first quarter. We were sitting here as a 12-7 ball game. The Brock Badgers were starting to run away with it. A quick timeout for the Mustangs. And what do you know, they finish up the half with a 20-12 lead, not allowing the Badgers to get another point in the final 2.5 minutes, and then to finish it up with that buzzer beater going into the second quarter, nothing but momentum on the side of the Mustangs. Great way to finish up the first quarter.
And you saw head coach of the Brock Badgers, Cy Kumbasith, have a conversation with the officiating crew at the buzzer rate there, obviously voicing his displeasure and his opinion on the call. However, this is one that the momentum could play a role here for these Badgers. Is that going to be one of those calls where they say, okay, it's us against two squads out there. Let's see if we can't dig in deep right now and create a little havoc here defensively on our own, just the way the Mustangs had over the last 5 minutes, and see if we can't claw our way back into this thing. Momentum, a fickle friend at times, Andrew.
Yeah, the Brock Badgers can't look at it as playing against two teams. They have to regain their composure, regain their focus, and come out here and play a strong second half. They're down by 8 points here with still a quarter to play here in the opening half. They cannot allow the Mustangs to continue their hot shooting to wrap up the first quarter. They have to find a way to counter.
Talking about wrapping up that first quarter, Laura Daly coming to play. 2 of 2 from downtown already. 8 points in that opening stanza. The Brock Badgers spread the scoring. Now an inbounding just in front of our bench right here. 3 points on that one. 3-point made to lead the team along with Santilli, also with three. Malin now from the arc finds Rosencrantz. Rosencrantz, great passer in the high post. Terrific ball movement by the Badgers. Gets Malin the open look. She cannot convert. Here comes Hancock. Calling out instructions. She finds Walensky. Walensky exceedingly fast with the ball in her hands. She can be exciting to watch. Letty left side. Letty off the glass.
The Brock Badgers have to move the ball beyond, or sorry, to bring it in from beyond the arc. Just 2-for-11 from three-point land. It's not working. They have to come in closer, play the paint. They've controlled the offensive rebounds. And as you see, they're playing very well in the paint, getting the basket to go.
And I got to tell you, Nicole Rosencrantz there, tough on the finish. She is a very difficult matchup, perhaps a little too quick for Letty in the high post, and simply too strong for just about anybody else to cover in the low post on this Mustang squad. A heck of a young player, third year. She's got all-star written all over her for these Brock Badgers, averaging a double-double on the season is Miss Rosencrantz. Give her a total of 13-plus points per game to go along with her rebounding, which is sitting at, pardon me, not quite the double-double yet, but sitting at 8 points per game. Did finish with a double-double in the last matchup between these two squads. Stangs, double high post set. Letty from the elbow, no good. McDonald all alone. Had a hand on the ball, did Polishuk, and McDonald earned herself a trip to the line. She had nobody between her and the basket if she could have just ripped that ball away.
Great play in the paint there.
McDonald short on the first attempt, 22-15. Mustangs in front. No good, 0-for-2 is Jory McDonald.
And those missed free throws will come back to haunt you. The last time these two teams met, of course, just the three-point difference, 69-66 victory for the Mustangs. And if you go missing free throws like that and allow the Badgers back into the game with a big three there to close the gap to 22-18, you're not going to be doing yourselves any favors if you're a Mustang.
Speaking of Mustang, guess who? Sarah Malin, former Mustang herself. Here comes Letty from the high post. Letty with that left hand. Start to wonder if the Badgers got the scouting report that Letty is left-handed. Here's Santilli, set at the arc, no good. Good battle inside with McDonald and Rosencrantz. Not sure who that one's going against. That looks like it's going against McDonald now as the rookie post player for these Mustangs banging away with the veteran. Veteran gets the call. I got to tell you, Andrew, thoroughly impressed by the Badgers' ball movement offensively right now. Running a four-out single-high offense with a baseline runner against this zone, and they have done an exceptional job of getting the Mustangs to move by way of the pass.
Yeah, the Mustangs have to find a way to break up those passing lanes, either get a hand in there, do whatever you can, because the one thing that the Badgers have been able to do very well this afternoon is move the ball, as you mentioned. If they can counter that somehow, it may break up the offensive control for the Badgers.
Caitlin Letty putting on a show this second quarter. That's one way to stifle the attack of Rosencrantz. Make her work on the defensive side. But speaking of her, she goes right at it once again. Going back to the line, and it looks like it's getting personal out there between Letty and Rosencrantz. This is shaping up to be a good one.
Mustang foul number 14, Lacey Knox. Her first
foul will be called on Knox on the play as Rosencrantz heads to the line. You see there Knox with the reach, as Ron Donnelly was in there too. Another big body off the bench for the Mustangs. Try to bang with the forwards of these Badgers. Rosencrantz already 5.6 boards to go along with an assist. Letty 9 points now in the ballgame. 4 of 5 shooting, and she is having a field day on that left side of the rim. Rosencrantz 0 of 2. And here comes Vaughn now working against Mackay. Double high set once again for the Mustangs. Letty, little hesitation, great move. Caitlin Letty setting up the defense. That's one I haven't seen from her in 5 years. That is an exceptional move of getting the defense to stand up out of their stance and get them on her hip.
Terrific play there from Letty, of course. Not backing down at all. having her way with the Badgers. So we got a whistle.
And there it is. That one looks like it might be going against Lacey Knox of the Mustangs. And she was trying to clear space, pushing that ball up the court. Mustangs up by 10, 7-10 to go. And this one, pardon me, thought we were getting a timeout called there, but Saikun Vaseth just making sure he got his subs into the game as he confers with the officiating crew. Badgers with an opportunity, completely falling asleep were the Mustangs, but Letty there to bail them out. Letty and Dally neck and neck as top Mustang performers of the half. Letty, a much quicker Kunick on her, continues to work, and perhaps Badgers have found a little something might work, sticking a guard on Caitlin Letty as she takes that high post position.
Yeah, they have to find a way to shut her down. They cannot allow Letty to have a big day for the Mustangs. That's the one player who will hurt you if you let her.
Speaking of hurt, Laura Daly, no good, but Polishuk clears. She'll hand off to Kunick. Single high with DeJong up in the high post. Rosencrantz on the bench. Sarah Mallon, no good. She will make a living at that arc, though, ladies and gentlemen. You've got to contest every time the ball's in Mallon's hands. Mustang faithful have seen that all too often. Jenny Vaughn to the rim. No foul called. Vaughn up with a little bit of a limp in her step. Looks like Walensky's going to come in to spell her. Not sure if it was a left or right ankle there. Mallon launches again. No good. Letty clears the board. Three Badgers in the backcourt, though. Mustangs could push. Hancock working against Kunick. Here's Mackay on Vaughn. Vaughn again looks to be slow to half step right now. Gets the ball to the arc, does Letty. Two-pointer. That's a long two. Laura Daly with a toe on the line.
Spreading the lead out to 10. Sorry, make that 12 now for the Mustangs.
Great ball rotation again by the Badgers. The guards on top, Vaughn and Hancock, having to do yeoman's work up there, chasing the ball around the perimeter. But of course, head coach Brian Jenks saw the stats coming in. Why wouldn't you? Mackay lifts the three, no good. As someone on the playground might say, the Badgers more adept at building houses the way they're throwing up bricks from the arc. Speaking of throwing it up, Hancock, drop it down.
Mustangs really playing with a whole bunch of confidence and momentum now here in the second quarter. The perimeter shooting, once again, just really not working for the Badgers. Trying to work it inside, that's being countered by the Mustangs, who are really taking control of things here as we hit the 5-minute remaining mark in the second quarter and, of course, the first half.
That was a great pass by Kunick, though. Polishuk thought she had a foul coming. Kunick, great vision from the top for these Badgers. Here's Hancock, one-on-one with Mallon. Mallon the better. She will clear the board and push back for the Badgers. Mallon at the arc, back to Kunick. Polishuk working that short corner underneath for these Badgers. Mackay loses the ball. Here come the Mustangs. Now Vaughn pushes for Daly. Two on four until help comes. Good job by DeJong reading that pass like a book. Speaking of books, it's been a tale of two cities out here from the three-point arc this afternoon. Andrew, the Mustangs absolutely shredding the mesh from downtown as they are 5 of 6 in the ball game. And the Brock Badgers, 3 of 18, not shy to launch, but they simply cannot find water from a boat right now behind that arc.
Yeah, and each time Badgers throw up a three-pointer and miss, it gives the Mustangs a bit of confidence, a bit of opportunity. Hey, we can head down the court. We can take a perimeter shot. If we miss, you know, we've got a big enough lead here, and the Badgers seem to be confident with their perimeter shooting, which has just not been working, which opens the door for the Mustangs to do as they please at the other end of the court.
And as you allude to, long shot equals long rebound, of course, and if you're the Mustangs, you would love to live in transition. We've seen spot-up threes in transition by these Mustangs already. Laura Daly, of course, coming to mind, really having one heck of a season is Laura Daly. But then when they get set in their half-court offense, Caitlin Letty 11 points in the ball game, 5 of 6 from the field, just shredding the mesh right now. The Mustangs, 60% from the field this ball game, Andrew.
Yeah, a very big improvement on their season. Of course, just the 41% shooting coming into this afternoon's matchup, as we mentioned off the top of the broadcast. And today, you would not know it by watching. If we did not mention that, you would think that they are a big shooting team. But that hasn't been the case this season. But here we are in the beginning of February as we make the push for the postseason. Something's clicking for the Mustangs here this afternoon. The big 33-18 lead here at Alumni Hall.
Well, you hit the nail on the head there, Andrew. This is certainly a time of year where you start to push towards the playoffs and you start to get your rotation set, start to shrink the bench perhaps just a little bit in the waning games of the OUA West schedule. There's a turnover. Mustangs. Johnny on the spot is Gallinardo. Can't believe that. Brian Chang, he's going to his bench right away to correct that. Walensky might be short-lived in her time on the floor there. Dally checking back into the ball game, as that is a rookie mistake there by Walensky. And just Johnny on the spot taking full advantage was the fourth-year player, Gallinardo. And that's one way to really let the Badgers back in quickly. They want to play that pressure game so they can try to create the turnovers. They know they've got the depth and the athleticism on their bench. The Mustangs must be smarter with the ball. And if Jenny Vaughn is hobbled at all right now, that could be something that coming down the fourth quarter of this ball game could really play a factor.
Yeah, it looked as though she may have tweaked her leg a few moments ago, but doesn't look to be too serious as she's there on the bench. And like you say, you know, the little mistakes, the rookie mistakes, as you call them, for the Mustangs, that opens the door once again for the Brock Badgers, who know that they're not playing well this afternoon. This isn't as though the Badgers are fighting here in this game. They're just not playing up to their potential. You allow them back into it, and you allow them to get on a run to finish the second quarter as the Mustangs did in the first, and we suddenly have a ball game again. 13-point lead with 4 minutes left. That's not exactly a safe lead in women's basketball here.
Well, and it's not going to be for lack of opportunities that the Brock Badgers lose this game. You look at their last game between these two squads back on January 14th at the Bob Davis Gym in St. Catharines. And the Badgers got up an incredible 83 shot attempts. Vaughn certainly looking healthy on that drive, but cannot convert. Here comes Gallinardo for the Badgers. But 83 shots in a ball game, that's incredible. The Mustangs got 59 themselves. Mustangs shooting nearly 50% in that ball game en route to that three-point victory, whereas the Badgers a shade over 30%.
Yeah, just nearly 26 of those shots. DeJong from the paint puts it off the board. That's good for two.
Taking a page out of the Caitlin Letty book right there as she drove hard right side. Here is Vaughn now. Finds Dally. She was working with Moss off the high screen. Neuenheisen puts her shoulder down. Can't get it to roll. McDonald can't control the rebound. Here come the Badgers pushing back. Kunick, DeJean, Mackay, Santilli. And running the baseline is Gallinardo. Kunick, three-pointer up. Three-pointer good. Devin Kunick.
Back come the Badgers closing the lead now. It's 33-25. And as soon as the Badgers start making their shots, this could turn into a very different ball game for the Mustangs. They miss yet another three-ball opportunity, opening the door once again for the Badgers.
Galley like what she saw. DeJean goes right at McDonald. Try to tie her up. We'll see if that one's on McDonald or Moss. But you're absolutely right, Andrew. This team, the Brock Badgers, as you take a look on the replay, Santilli pulling up the arc, finds her big, diving through the key. And DeJean had her mind made up real early. That one will go against McDonald. She heads to the bench. The Brock Badgers are a volume shooting team. And law of averages state they're going to make some eventually. Can you play enough defense long enough if you're the Western Mustangs? Can you control the ball long enough to prevent the Badgers from getting so many opportunities? Take a look at the live stats for these Mustangs. And already in this ball game, the Badgers, 36 shot attempts to the Mustangs, 25. Mustangs shooting over 50% from the field. The Badgers, 10 of 36 for less than 30%.
Yeah, 10 for 36. You hear that number, and you have to start thinking if you're the coaching staff of the Badgers. maybe not necessarily why are we taking so many shots, but what are the quality of those shots? Just heaving it up from beyond the arc, the three-point shooting isn't there so far today for the Badgers. You might want to be saying to your players, hey, you know, instead of trying to take off with that many shots per game, maybe instead of quantity, focus on the quality of the shooting.
Dally having just inbounded in front of our bench. Talk about quality. You got to talk about Laura Dally and Caitlin Letty as they are leading this Mustang charge. Letty trying to set up a spin back. Great find. Knox was diving to the net, but that one tipped away. 2 minutes to play now in the first half of basketball. Mackay, miscommunication with her teammate, and you can see the frustration on the Badgers' faces right now as that miscommunication leads to a freebie for the Mustangs. Knox is going to take a break. Rondinelli coming back into the ball game. And this one, an easy opportunity here for the Mustangs to capitalize on the Badgers' mistake. 33-27, Mustangs in front. Badgers doing a good job of closing the gap this quarter. Mustangs not getting as many easy looks at the basket. The Badgers certainly haven't picked up their defensive intensity. Good penetration by Dally. Ball movement by Moss. Here comes Vaughn. Nice job of sidestepping Rosencrantz. A great job body control to avoid the foul as Rosencrantz had her dialed up. Here comes Rosencrantz. Finds her teammate DeJong on the baseline. This is something interesting. We're wondering how long it was going to take head coach Kumasev to get here. He's got both Rosencrantz and DeJong in the game together right now to play a little high-low against this zone of the Mustangs. Good dive inside by DeJong. Can't find her. 13 and counting on the shot clock. DeJong on the baseline. Rosencrantz high post. Vaughn doing a nice job trying to cut her off. Here's Rosencrantz. Asked to create something from 15 feet. She can't finish, but DeJong with the board finds Mackay. Very athletic. Emily Mackay. Mackay doing a very good job in the paint, getting that rebound. Two defenders all over her. No challenge too big. As Vaughn goes hard to the net, does not get the call she was looking for. Turned immediately to the official and asked him where was the whistle, as there was plenty of contact, though it looked to me like Vaughn certainly initiated it, not getting the veteran call there. Polishuk short. Here comes Vaughn pushing back, looking for help. She's one-on-one with Polishuk, making her dance. Left hand, no good, but a foul called. Whistle coming a half step late, perhaps, but the whistle nonetheless. Vaughn finally up, shaking her head, will head to the free throw line. But again, I got to say, Rosencrantz, her athleticism, her skill set at that power forward spot in the high post right now. DeJong able to work on that low post, short corner in particular, along the baseline. This is the lineup, I think, Andrew, that for these Brock Badgers, they've got the size to manhandle Western just a little bit here. And yeah, I think size got something.
Certainly. Size is in the advantage of the Badgers as we close up the first half here. That has been proven. That will be something that the Badgers coaching staff will want to focus on in, during halftime and into the second half, as they've managed to close the gap a bit here in the second quarter, but still trailing. They have to find a way to keep up with the Mustangs.
30 seconds to play, 5-point lead for the Stangs, 10 on the shot clock. Mackay looking baseline, nothing brewing, finds Polishuk, gets it to DeJong in the corner. DeJong a long two. Here come the Mustangs, shot clock off, 14 seconds, 34-31, Mustangs in front. Vaughn checks the clock, 7 seconds and counting. Lines up Mackay, left side to the hoop, glass and good, Jenny Vaughn gets it to go just before the buzzer, reinstating the 5-point lead that the Mustangs will take to the locker room. 36-31 the score, an exciting first half of basketball here at Alumni Hall. We're going to take a quick break away for the halftime festivities, but don't you go anywhere when we come back. We'll be right back.
Mechanic by day, soccer coach by night. I've been doing it for years now. It's fun. I use my Prius V to transport all of the equipment to our tournaments. Our last one was north of the city. I fed three kids, soccer balls, coolers, equipment, safety gear, pylons, and nets. I had no idea how much space was in that car. We played five games that day. Ended up third overall. Everyone was really happy. I didn't have to stop for gas on the way home either. The gauge barely moved. Ice cream was another story. The kids, they're never full. Ever.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the Western Mustangs and Marching Band. I just want a good game. This might be a good game. I'm out. Have some chair, have some wings. Oh, yeah. You got any voting in or cheering interest there?
No, I didn't see much. No. I was a Packers fan for a while there, but I'll forget the Packers one right. I'll be more surprised if you see more of them.
Thank you.
is pitiful in comparison, and Letty gets it going for the last day. That's a bad 30% in that opening half of play. Certainly it'll be a matter of getting the ball and shots to go. And the Mustangs continuously has the machines in our offensive end. Shooting that big difference in this ballgame. 50% shooting down for the Mustangs, where the Brock Badgers just 12-40. Half of those shots coming from beyond the arc, just 4-20 from 3-point vantage, and it's just not working. The Badgers have to move in. They cannot rely on perimeter shooting, and they have to find a way to contain the capability of
Letty
and Dally. Dally 10 points on the road, including 4 of 8 from the field, 2 of 4 from downtown. Jenny Bond getting to the rim over and over again. She's been 2-2 from the free throw line there. As the Mustangs will apply some backdoor pressure here, trapping defense, and that's going to lead to the turnover. Great job by the Mustangs to play the full court, and that's something that our young players watch have to learn there, Andrew, that applying the full court pressure does not necessarily mean you have to get the steal. Taking a look out on the court right now for the Badgers, the two players who are making a difference in the first half for the Badgers, Rosencrantz and DeJong, are on the bench to start the second half, and you're trailing by 9 points. Not sure what the thinking is. Maybe they're saving those two players for the fourth quarter, trying to claw back into this one. But when you have two players who were effective in the first half, and to start them on bench, maybe it's the strategy that they're going with. But it's certainly something to be questioned if you're a Mustangs supporter.
Mallon certainly got back out there quickly, coming off the bench to start the third quarter of play. Number 5 for the Badgers. She was second on the team in scoring in that opening half, hitting 2 threes for her 6 points. DeJong led the way with 8. Rosencrantz, 5 points and 6 boards in that first half. Rosencrantz in wearing number 15 there for the Badgers as she will head down the court. Certainly one stat that does jump off the page in favor of the Badgers, 12 offensive rebounds. They are doing a great job on the glass, trying to give themselves extra opportunities. Not surprising given that they put up 40 shots in that first half. So we'll have to see if the Mustangs can do a better job on the glass.
Yeah, that's the one area that the Mustangs do have to improve upon. They have been able to grab 18 defensive rebounds.
Offensive board once again for the Badgers. Rosencrantz high post. Rosencrantz making money all day from that spot.
6 points on the afternoon for Rosencrantz. And you look at the offensive numbers, or rebound numbers for the Badgers, and you have to think if they can keep on rebounding and improve their shooting, they'll close the gap and really make this a ball game. But until that happens, the Mustangs are in full control of this one.
8 points the difference now. Mustangs 41, the Badgers 33. Mackay following that big collision with Letty defensively a moment ago. Here's Polishuk now. Rosencrantz diving, finds the middle of the key. Misses the six-footer, but Mackay, second old board of the quarter for Emily Mackay. The Stangs doing a nice job defensively, getting in the way of Rosencrantz in the middle, but they got to find a way to keep Mackay off the glass. That's Hancock, the rookie right now, who's trying to box her out, but just boxing air has been Hancock. Cannot find Mackay, who's been active. 41-35 now.
Jenny Fawn just held to the one basket to finish up the first half of play as she's pressured in the paint.
Veteran move by Mallon right there, reaching in to grab a piece of ball, turn it over for the Badgers, getting a free possession.
Mallon, of course, the former Western Mustang, as we mentioned in the first half, battling very hard here this afternoon back at Alumni Hall. Maybe a bit of a look at what the Mustangs are missing, but so far, I think the Mustangs are doing just fine without.
Rosencrantz on the finish. There's a player any team would love to have around Ontario, if not the country. Rosencrantz getting a great dish from Polishuk. Vaughn trying to exploit the mismatch. Went hard from the top. Last touch by the Badgers. Mustangs will maintain possession. It's Neuenhuyzen sent the check back in for Knox. Mustangs on defense have done a nice job of forcing the Badgers into late shot clock opportunities. And when that happens, it certainly limits what you're going to do offensively. Hancock takes the contact and converts.
Great effort by Hancock there in the paint, going hard to the basket. Being rewarded for her effort.
Mallon, three ball. Sarah Mallon gets the feet set. And she can knock it down. Heavy hitter from downtown, Sarah Mallon. Just loving these home former home court meshes at Alumni Hall. She knows the sight lines, that's for sure.
5'8", fourth year senior from Fond Hill, Ontario.
Vaughn with toe on the line. Her big toe just a little too big on that one. Long deuce, 45-40. Already 4 minutes gone by. This has been a great pace of play thus far this afternoon, Andrew. Good flow to the game, not surprising given the way both teams want to play. Transition ball, Mackay, three-pointer, no good. Vaughn all alone, she'll break out for the Stangs. Finds Hancock running, left side, Hancock, great job by Kunick. Letty on the offensive board. But that one going to go against Letty for clearing out the Badger. Let's take another look at this, wave off the basket. This is Vaughn pushing the ball up the court, finds Hancock. She can't convert. Kunick playing D, strips it away cleanly. Now take a look at Letty as she throws the right hand into Rosencrantz. Rosencrantz hits the deck, and Letty whistled for the foul, her second personal of the ball game.
That's just a bit too aggressive on Letty's part. It looked as though it was a great play from the veteran Mustang, but just a little bit too aggressive. The free hand, not much she could really do on that one. Trying to get position, and it causes her there.
Ball movement by the Badgers. Rosencrantz trying to drop a pretty dime there. Mustangs come away with it, up by five. 5 minutes to play now. Here's Knox at the arc. Knox, high arc and shot to get it over Polishuk. She'll get a rebound, blocked by Rosencrantz. And last touch by the third year Badger. Coming into the game, DeJong now will give Rosencrantz a break. Going one for one with those two big forwards for the Badgers rather than playing them together again. It was about that 2 minute mark in the second quarter where DeJong and Rosencrantz found themselves on the court together. We'll see if the Badgers go back to that. As you mentioned, Andrew, did seem to have some effect for Brock. Letty, quick spin left hand. Letty loving to go one-on-one against DeJong this afternoon.
Great job there from Letty, making up for the earlier minor mistake. Replying in fine fashion there.
And the passing by these Badgers, zip, zip, zip around the court. And I'm curious to see, Andrew, how long it's going to be before the Badgers start to take advantage of the aggressive Mustang defense and how quick the Mustangs are to adapt to the next pass. A few more ball fakes might really open up some more passing lanes for these Badgers, as the Mustangs are so quick to react right now.
Yeah, you just look at the passing lanes wide open for the Badgers all afternoon here so far. That has been the one bright spot of their game.
Knox from Vaughn. Knox looking for a hole, can't find one. Here's Hancock, a little handoff for Dally. Dally can't get the three. Knox will take it. Barely catches rim. Letty, great hustle to get after it, but that'll be out of bounds. Turn it over to the Badgers. Mustangs up seven right now, as they did take a five-point lead into this third quarter. That has swelled by a basket. Subs both ways here. Santilli, the rookie, back in for the Badgers. McDonald, rookie for the Mustangs, will give Letty a break. As Letty, 15 points now, 7 of 8 from the field. Give her 4 boards, 2 assists. As she has come to play in the matchup she's had against DeJong, she's taken advantage with Letty has with her quickness against DeJong. But now it'll be McDonald for the Mustangs. See if she can contain the bigs of the Badgers. Ball movement continues for these Badgers. Here's Ralph from the arc, catches nothing but air. There's Dally. That ball could have been tipped. And a traveling violation by Dally as she and Vaughn, slight miscommunication there. Vaughn thought Dally was going to push this one all by herself. Dally certainly has the skill set
Rebecca Bonds checks in for Laura Dowling.
Play the point position. And she will take a quick rest now. Vaughn McDonald, Hancock, Knox, and Moss on the court in that 2-3 zone. Very, very active are the Mustangs in this zone, pushing the Badgers shooters a good 2 feet beyond the arc more often than not. But here's a close-up look for the Badgers. Short is Ralph. Knox now pushing back. She's 1-on-3 to start. And the Mustangs will settle things down. Here's McDonald. She'll set a high screen for Vaughn. Vaughn going left side. Gets a look at DeJong. Doesn't like it. Moss now. 10 seconds on the shot clock. Knox on the curl. Stop and pop. Lacey Knox.
Great job by the Mustangs there. Spreading the lead to 9.
3 minutes now to go in the third quarter. Sarah Mallon set the check back in for the Brock Badgers. DeJong finds Santilli as the Mustang marching band, giving the Badgers all they can handle with the crowd noise. Santilli with 1 second on the shot clock. Perhaps she didn't realize it. Shot no good there. Waved off by the officials. And that, a rookie with her head down right there, unaware of the shot clock, creates a problem as the Badgers could not be heard from the sideline with Santilli right in front of the marching band as she was.
Mustangs looking to close up the third quarter as they did in the first quarter to really start to run away with this game as we head to the fourth. These two teams, of course, battled back in January to a 69-66 final score victory for the Mustangs. I'm sure they would like to widen the gap a bit and put this game away before the closing moments. Big three ball from Jenny Vaughn. And as I say, trying to put things away, Jenny Vaughn with the big three ball.
That was from another zip code. Jenny Vaughn throwing it up with the shot clock beginning to cause trouble. Here's Mallon wide open. Sarah Mallon, tickle its wine for three.
Sarah Mallon and Jenny Vaughn really exchanging blows here in the second half. The former teammates, and another big three ball for the Mustangs. Really starting to shoot the lights out here this afternoon. That three ball,
it's contagious out here. I don't think Hancock's missed a three all game. DeJong high post. I'll tell you, those of you a fan of the offensive fireworks, you are being treated to them right now as Vaughn will finally slow things down for the Mustangs. 55-43. A little bit of tit for tat both ways here. Badgers and Mustangs. This one a great one, ladies and gentlemen. Mustangs getting the better of the Badgers right now. 12-point lead. Here's McDonald one-on-one inside. Jory McDonald. I got to tell you, Andrew, a whole lot of defense being played right now, not a lot of D.
Certainly seems to be the case.
Three ball put up. Gallinaro, the basket. Absolutely doubled or tripled in size right now for these shooters as they are on fire right now. Here's Moss, likes the three. And Moss mugged on the shot attempt. No whistle goes. Less than a minute to play now. Moss left to wonder what happened there. As Cunicle fire, no good. Moss with the rebound.
Moss may have been a bit quick with that three-point attempt on the last play. Took the pass pretty quickly and let the shot go. Didn't really set her feet too well. Jenny Vaughn just rims out on another three ball. And if the Mustangs really want to get into a three-point shooting competition with the Badgers, go right ahead, because the Badgers have not been converting very well from beyond the arc. But this game, just 9-point game for the Mustangs. Just 10 seconds left as we wrap things up here in the third quarter.
8 seconds and counting. Vaughn sizing up Gallinaro. She'll go one-on-one right side. DeJong was waiting. Vaughn! Mustangs swell their lead, 59-48 after 30 minutes of play, but you cannot turn your eyes away from the screen right now, as it has been an absolute offensive explosion this quarter.
Taking a look at Jenny Vaughn going hard to the basket to wrap up the third quarter, as she did in the second quarter. She knows how big momentum can be for her team, spreading out the lead now, 59-48 for the Lady Mustangs. And this is a lead that they cannot sit on as we enter the fourth quarter here. They have to keep the pedal to the metal and continuing to apply pressure here to the Badgers, who are really searching for answers here at the end of the third quarter.
23-17, the quarter score there. Mustangs swell the lead by six. As you look at some of the numbers, the Mustangs continuing their hot shooting at over 50% in the ball game. The Badgers inching up now, shooting 33%, only 7 of 28 from downtown. However, the Mustangs better than 50% behind the arc at 7 of 13. That zone defense by the Western Mustangs still causing some trouble for the Badgers in the half-court set, which is why that transition basketball that the Badgers want to play, they are looking for opportunities to push things in the open court, and they're still looking to find the right recipe when they get stuck in a half-court set. But again, I got to say it, I know we keep going back to the same idea, Andrew, but when will DeJong and Rosencrantz find themselves out there together for that half-court set? Of course, that limits what you can do in transition, perhaps, but it is a recipe perhaps the Badgers might have to try to cook something up with, because they have 10 minutes to try to erase an 11-point Mustang margin.
Yeah, it's a real head-scratcher that those two players have not been out on the court more often together for the Badgers. It worked effectively towards the end of the first half and opted not to go with it in the third. Not sure what the thinking is, but we'll see if the strategy pays off here. It's a big gap to close, 59-48 for the Mustangs. The Badgers have quite the hill to climb here in the fourth.
One strategy that has been working to a T, however, Sarah Mallon, the former Mustang, coming back to her old haunt and absolutely scorching the Stangs from downtown. She has taken 9 shots in the game, every one of them from behind the arc. She's hit 4 as Walensky once again. Turnover against Walensky. The rookie having a tough afternoon here for the Mustangs, keeping control of the ball, but her speed in the full court pressure D can be essential. Olshock working against Vaughn. She'll give it to Mallon, who finds Mackay out there with Santilli and DeJong to start the fourth. Mallon trying to create space with the ball fake. DeJong in the high post. Here's Santilli, launches the 3, no good. Mackay skies for the rebound. She's had an incredible afternoon on the old glass. Weak side rebounding against the zone, something every coach knows you've got to take care of, otherwise you will give up way too many second chances. Santilli again from 3. This time she's dialed in.
Santilli given the opportunity there. The Mustang defenders backed off for just a half second, and that cost them. Santilli able to get the 3 ball away. Badgers doing a fine job in the rebounding department. A big part, of course, as you said, comes from McKee. But unfortunately, we haven't been able to convert on those rebound opportunities as DeJong makes her presence felt there with yet another basket, losing the lead to 8 for the Mustangs.
And that'll force a timeout there by the Western Mustangs as they will settle the troops. Just to finish your point on Emily Mackay, she has 6 boards in the ball game, 5 of them on the offensive end, and she has done a great job of crashing, weak side in particular. I think they're just working on the scoreboard here, as I believe it could be up to 53. However, we'll wait to see as the next points go up. Does not look like DeJong's basket has been counted yet, so we'll see if that gets up there. DeJong, you see on the replay, finishing over top of Letty. Letty having herself a heck of a ball game, of course. Letty already 15 points in the ball game. 1 of 4 Mustangs in double figures thus far, as it is, pardon me, Vaughn, Letty, Daly, and Hancock all with double digits on the score sheet. Hancock has not missed from downtown yet, as it is a score of, it's 11 points on 3 of 3 shooting from downtown, 4 of 7 from the field. And just curious to see, it does not look like they counted that last basket from DeJong yet. Still in there, it finally goes up on the board. 59-33. DeJong will get credit for the deuce just prior to the timeout whistle. It will be a Mustang ball to inbound. Full court pressure by the Badgers. Knox and Hancock in the backcourt with Vaughn. Daly and Letty in the front court. Daly hiding out in the corner. Mallon watching her. And they'll whistle things back into play. Here are the Mustangs. Knox gets it back to Vaughn, working against Mackay. 6-point lead for the Mustangs. 8.5 to play in the ball game. Steal there by Polishuk. Knox a little lazy with the pass. Rosencrantz is back out there for the Badgers. She'll get rid of it. Look to settle into her high post home. Santilli wide open. 3. Kayla Santilli can't find it. But Mackay, once again, weak side board. I'll tell you, Mackay wants to get rid of this ball just so she can go to glass, I think, because she has absolutely played a huge role for these Badgers, but so has Sarah Mallon.
Mallon closing the gap to just 3 points. The Mustangs started off the fourth with that 11-point lead. That has been erased as this game is wide open. Of course, just a 69-66 ball game back on January 14th as Vaughn puts up the shot, draws foul.
Well, we're going to wave that off. Actually, traveling violation first on Vaughn. And Mallon, just to go back to her for a moment, 15 points, 5-3 bombs for Sarah Mallon. What a ball game she's having in her return to the Alumni Hall hardwood. 50% from behind the arc. Here's Rosencrantz. Great move to get around Letty. Can't finish with the left hand. Rosencrantz, right side. That'll do.
Rosencrantz doing a fine job grabbing her own board, working in the paint, laying it in. 59-58 for the Mustangs.
Letty, great job getting position. Can't get it to drop, but she'll go to the free throw line. Fantastic job of working without the ball by Caitlin Letty to absolutely bury her defender underneath the hoop. That was Rosencrantz. Had no choice but to foul lest she give up the gimme. And in a one-point game, you're going to make Letty earn it from the stripe. Letty up and down good on the first. Rosencrantz now 3 fouls in the ball game. Second one good as well. Still just a one possession game for these Western Mustangs. And Brock Badgers and Letty getting in Rosencrantz's way. Rosencrantz couldn't get the ball to the deck in time. That'll turn things over. Mustang possession just in front of the announcer's booth. Mallon, Mackay, Santilli, Rosencrantz, and Polishuk for the Badgers. Gallinardo getting ready to check back in. Vaughn, Letty, Knox, Daly, and Hancock for the Mustangs. Hancock, a real savior this afternoon from three-point land. Here's Vaughn! In and out, no good. I tell you, at this point in the game, you're more surprised when they don't go, Andrew.
Yeah, the three-point shooting really opened up in the third quarter towards the end there for both teams. Vaughn unable to get that shot to go. As you said, just the one possession ball game here. 61-58. Opportunity for the Badgers to knot things up here with just under 7 minutes to play.
Mustangs still in that 2-3 zone. It has been also active. But Sarah Mallon, the one-man zone buster. Here she is for 3! Sarah Mallon ties the game! Looking over at the Mustang bench, I see Amanda Anderson, assistant coach now with the Mustangs. Can't help but crack a little bit of a smile. Can't count how many assists she racked up in her career by doing just that, giving it to Mallon with her feet set.
Sarah Mallon has been one woman wrecking crew for the Badgers this afternoon. There's no bitterness towards the Mustangs, I'm sure, from Mallon, just the decision she made to head down to St. Catharines, Ontario to continue her collegiate career. And really coming back to haunt the Mustangs today, just going off from three-point land up to close to 20 points, I'd have to think, at this point now, as she has tied this one up. And after leading by 11 at the start of the fourth quarter, the Western Mustangs back on their heels, all tied up. They'll have to find another gear to come away with this one, as the January 14th score of 69-66 could be a familiar sight on the scoreboard here with just under 6 minutes to play.
And I'll tell you, Brock Badgers begging for the travel call. This one a big one right now. The travel not called, and Rosencrantz forced to commit her fourth foul of the ball game. Rosencrantz has certainly provided that inside presence for the Badgers, but she's going to be on the bench for the next minute or so, lest she pick up her fifth foul. Letty will go to the hoop. Sarah Mellon, as you said, 18 points in the ball game, absolutely lighting it up from all over right now, and she has been just incredible for these Brock Badgers this afternoon.
There's no doubt that Mountain's competitive spirit was burning coming back to London today. I mean, as I say, probably not too much bitterness, but that competitive spirit is there in an athlete, that you always want to put on a good show against a former team, and she has definitely done that today as the Badgers tied things up once again. Mackay with the basket.
Mackay has been incredible weak side boards for these Badgers. Here's Dally, the bank open on a step to me. Laura Dally. This game, I tell you, Andrew, is going to be one where we might just sit back and enjoy, because I'll tell you, one of the better women's basketball games we've seen here in a while. These Western Mustangs and Brock Badgers giving the fans all they came to see. Mackay again with the offensive rebound. Mustang band playing hard, and that one waved off. Shot clock violation once again, and the marching band deserves a little bit of kudos from this Mustang bench, as the Badgers bench and coaching staff trying to alert their players to the shot clock coming to a close, and they could not hear them as they are playing right in front of the Badgers right now. Turnover again by the Mustangs. That's a stat you mentioned right off the top, Andrew. Will that become a factor down the stretch here, as that one kicked out of bounds by Vaughn. Loose ball on the floor as DeJong couldn't handle it. 14 seconds on the shot clock. Mustangs up by three.
And I tell you what, Kevin, whoever comes away with the victory this afternoon, it could be a big one. It could be a big one for the Brock Badgers, that they were able to battle back under rough road conditions here at Alumni Hall to pick up the victory. And if the Mustangs are able to hold on for the win to defeat the 11-6 Brock Badgers, who have been nationally ranked this season, that could be a very big swing as they make the push for the postseason. So plenty on the line here in the closing minutes this afternoon.
Great stop there by DeJong. Can't make it happen. Mackay flying in. Can't get the loose ball. You know, until just a couple of moments ago when Letty hit those free throws, the Mustangs had only had a single basket in this quarter. Now up to 7 points in the quarter. And a timeout going to be taken here by the Brock Badgers, with Mustangs having possession on the end line. It has been back and forth in this ball game. The Mustangs jumped out to that 36-31 lead at the half and had a great shooting quarter in the third, 23-17 the quarter score. But now the Badgers only trailing by three, thanks to 15 points in the early goings here. 4 minutes, 16 seconds left on the game clock. And it is going to be one heck of a finish, especially when you consider Sarah Mallett coming back into the game for these Badgers, who has just shredded the Mustang defense. 6 of 11 in the ball game for her 18 points. Emily Mackay, let's not forget about her, with a half dozen offensive rebounds already. But countering for the Mustangs, Caitlin Letty. How can you not talk about the young woman? 7 of 8 from the field, 19 points, 4 boards. Top to bottom, Andrew, both rosters, just an outstanding ball game.
Yeah, everyone has shown up to play today. No one having a disappointing game. All guns are firing here. Coaching staff has to be impressed with the effort of both their teams. As I said, who's ever been on the floor has shown up. No costly mistakes, no stupid fouls, nothing of that sort. It's just been a classic battle in the OUA West division here this afternoon.
I'll tell you, we talked about it several times already. Shooting percentage for the Badgers, a volume shooting team. They're going to make some shots eventually. That percentage having creeped up noticeably since halftime, up to 36% now, but they are 10 of 34 from the three-point arc. Hancock getting great position. Ball movement aplenty by the Mustangs. Letty one-on-one with Mackay. There comes the double team by DeJong. Letty called for the travel, and she had thoughts in her mind going against the much smaller Mackay. DeJong came on over to seal things up. DeJong still on the court. Rosencrantz still on the bench. Mallon, Mackay, Santilli, and Kunick also out there for the Badgers. Every one of them knows how to shoot the three for the Mustangs. It's Hancock, Vaughn, Letty, Daly, and Moss. Coming up on 3:40 to play in the fourth quarter. Mackay, baseline pull up, no good. Santilli working hard for the rebound. Weak side, can't come up with it. He almost wants Santilli to be the one putting that up so Mackay can get to glass again, as she's done an incredible job flying in weak side for the Badgers.
It will be most interesting to see how the Mustangs defend Sarah Mallon here in the closing moments, because she has been lights out. I don't know if they throw an extra defender on her or find a way to shut her down. Big basket from the paint there for the Mustangs. Kevin Letty laying it in.
Vaughn had missed, but Letty there to clean up the garbage. Here's DeJong right back to Mackay. They're going to leave her all alone from the arc, showing no respect for Mackay's outside shot. DeJong now goes right to the basket, but she traveled before she found Mackay. Mackay was coming in there getting ready to go to boards, and Rosencrantz up off the bench with Polishuk for the Badgers. She replaced DeJong and the rookie Santilli. So four starters for the Badgers plus Mallon. Mustangs in front by five, 68-63. Vaughn trying to turn Mackay on a dime here. Letty one-on-one with Rosencrantz. She'll go middle. Kunick was waiting for her. Rosencrantz clears the board, but Moss working hard. Rebecca Moss steals away from the Mustangs.
That could be a very key turn over here. Just a five-point lead with 2:30 left to play, and right back come the Badgers. And who else with her own turnover?
Emily Mackay, no surprise there. Rosencrantz throws one up to the rim. She'll earn a trip to the free throw line. You saw Jenny Vaughn taking another look, but let's take a look again as Moss, Johnny on the spot. You see her just shrouded there by Rosencrantz. Keeps active after the ball does Moss and comes away with it for the Mustangs. A huge play there, as you mentioned. Then Rosencrantz working hard at the other end. She's at the line. Vaughn could not believe that there was not a foul call on the reach-in when Mackay snuck things away from her. Rosencrantz misses, board controlled by Letty. Mackay right on her. Letty gets the front court, finds Vaughn. 4-point difference, 2 minutes to play. Badgers need a stop here or they'll have to start fouling the Mustangs. 6 seconds on the shot clock for Vaughn. Getting a ball screen from Letty. Letty steps out with the hip, no whistle. Vaughn finishes that on the rim. All alone, the defense had evaporated for the Badgers, and that was the worst thing that could happen. Back to the 6-point lead, under 2 minutes to go. Mackay, she'll be left alone out there as the Mustangs only worried about her when she steps inside the arc. She misses. Moss in the backcourt, she finds Vaughn. You don't want to foul Vaughn as she can convert. Here is Hancock, three ball. Hancock, no good. Kunick with the rebound. She has to push. Minute 30 to play. Wide open. Polishuk up the court. Great recovery by the Mustangs, forcing the turnover by the Badgers. Incredible defense played by the Mustangs when they needed it most.
Mustangs really tightening the grip, looking for that final nail in the coffin. Hancock tried to throw it down with the hammer. Unfortunately, misses her first three ball of the afternoon. Not much point in taking the three-point shot with the six-point lead, but now as we enter into the 1:25 remaining mark of fourth quarter, you get to the foul territory, and trying to stop the clock for the Badgers in a six-point lead is somewhat comfortable right now for the Mustangs, but just one big three-pointer from Sarah Mallon, and this game is long from being over.
And let's set things up for you now. As you say, less than a minute and a half to play. Only a two-possession game. The 6-point difference for the Mustangs. Sarah Mallon committed to a one-possession game in a hurry. For the Mustangs, the free throw shooting, not one of their strengths on the season. Only 63% on the season for the Mustangs. A number that could come up to haunt them in the latter stages. Really the only shooter of any effectiveness from the free throw line is Jenny Vaughn, shooting 78% coming into the ball game. And as you look at what's happened here on the afternoon, free throw percentage 67%, 10 of 15 are the Western Mustangs. Those numbers highlighted by Jenny Vaughn at 4 of 6. Letty actually perfect from the line, belying her 60% free throw mark on the season. She is 5 of 5 from the line. So other than Letty and Vaughn, you feel pretty good putting most other shooters to the free throw stripe. It is Vaughn, Moss, Hancock, and Letty on the court with Dally. Dally inbounds. Gets it right back. She will survey the defense. Polishuk, Mallon, Rosencrantz, Mackay, and Kunick for the Badgers. Minute 15 to play. Hancock right under the hoop, kicks it out. The Mustangs doing a good job working the shot clock. 7 seconds for Vaughn. She'll work against Polishuk. One-on-one, left side, gets the whistle. And two shots coming up at the stripe for Jenny Vaughn. She was left one-on-one to make something happen, but the Badgers forced to foul. Jenny Vaughn going to the stripe. That foul called on Polishuk. Gallinardo coming into the ball game, replacing her. Another three-point shooter out there for the Badgers. Rosencrantz, the lone forward in the game. Vaughn halfway down but pops back out. However, one or two really doesn't matter. Just got to have one of the two to make it a three-possession game. This one, the big one, up and down, three-possession game it is. Vaughn showing a little bit of ice in the veins on that one.
Timeout called here, I do believe.
That one called by the Badgers, of course, as head coach Cy Kumbasith will set things up. Brian Ching, coach of the Mustangs, will set his defense. 7-point margin, meaning it is a three-possession ball game. 1 minute left to play in the regulation, and we do say regulation now because, of course, you never know what could happen here. We've seen stranger things, and both teams have been shooting oh so well here in the fourth quarter. It's been a wild one. Started off as a real tough shooting afternoon for the Badgers. The Mustangs able to build that 5-point halftime lead, swell it to an 11-point lead coming into the fourth quarter, but give the Brock Badgers full credit as they closed the gap, and they had tied it for a time, Andrew. But now the Mustangs, with 1 minute left, 7 points, and they're close, but the Badgers certainly are not out.
Yeah, I know this game is still long from being over. I mean, that looks like a big lead, 7 points is, but all it takes is a quick three-pointer, a quick turnover, another three-pointer, and all of a sudden we've got a one-point ball game. Do not count out the Brock Badgers here in the final minute of play. Just a reminder that following this women's game, we will have men's basketball action for you here on Rogers TV. The Mustangs taking on the Badgers in men's action. That should be another exciting game as we are all set for an exciting final minute of play here between the women.
Rosencrantz able to get into 6 feet. Can't finish though. Vaughn working against Gallinardo. She is all over her. Kumbasith can't believe no whistle. The whistle finally comes now. That one against the Badgers, sending Jenny Vaughn. Pardon me, that will not send Vaughn to the line. The next foul on the Badgers will. They are not in the penalty situation yet.
Yeah, it looks as though, taking a look at the replay, that she did get the reach in there. It appeared that Jan Leonardo is trying for the foul much earlier than it came. Took quite a few moments there to get the whistle.
7 seconds on the shot clock. Here's Dally. Letty slips away. Letty, and that'll be the final nail in the coffin. 36 seconds to play. The Mustangs on top by a 9. Three threes needed here by the Badgers. They can't afford to look for too many opportunities. They got to let it fly if they're hoping to come back in this one. Rosencrantz inside working against Letty. She finishes at the rim. 23 seconds. It has to be a quick foul here. Mallon looking for Dally. She's trying to get the whistle. Finally does. 19 and a half ticks on the clock as Dally will go to the free throw line. But I'll tell you, that last basket there by Letty, methinks that is going to be the last line written in this one. as the Stags up by 7 right now with a chance to increase that to 9. It will be a 3-possession game no matter what happens here at the line. Rosencrantz out, nothing but shooters on the court for the Badgers. Dally up and good with the first one, of course, makes no difference.
Dally putting on the finishing touches of a very terrific ball game for the Mustangs this afternoon. Had their backs against the wall in the third quarter, battled through it after building that big lead in the first half. The Badgers responded, it looked as though they might be able to throw the knockout punch. That was not the case.
Gallinardo keeps it interesting. 3-ball, 10 seconds, 6-point lead. Dally dancing in the backcourt. The Badgers cannot find the steal. And this one is going to be all she wrote, ladies and gentlemen. Vaughn will just hold it to dribble out the clock. And ball game over. Mustangs win 75-69. It started off much closer, perhaps, than it finished. But what really ended up costing the Badgers in the end, a tough shooting afternoon.
Yeah, certainly. You know what? The shooting just was not there. They had the third quarter where they were lights out. But other than that, the three other quarters of the afternoon,